Let us write a program in Python in order to print first n Fibonacci numbers. Right, so consider that user enters the value of n as 10. So here first 10 Fibonacci numbers are printed. So let us understand this little bit. So your initial value of Fibonacci number is 0 and the next number is 1. Then for rest of the remaining terms, we get it as follows. So 0 plus 1 is added and we get the sum of these 0 and 1. So this 0 plus 1 is 1, so 1 is printed here. Then next 1 plus 1, so 2 is printed here. Then next 1 plus 2, 3 is printed here. 2 plus 3, 5. 3 plus 5, 8. 5 plus 8, 13, and so on till 34. So I hope you got the logic that how the numbers are exchanging and the sum of previous two values is printed in the as the next number, right? So we are supposed to write the code in order to generate this series, right? So let's go to the editor to write the code. So what I can do, first of all, n, I'll consider k here for the input, int input. So let me ask the user to enter the value of k. Once this is done, now I'll just call a function in Python. So that will be a user defined function which we are going to define. Let me name the function as pf, that means which stands for print Fibonacci, and let me pass this argument k. So I'll just define my function here. So the function name pf and it receives the argument k. So this function is just supposed to print the numbers, print first n Fibonacci numbers or first 10 Fibonacci numbers or first k Fibonacci numbers, right? Now if you observe, this a starts with the value 0. So a assignment, so a I will assign with 0 and then b I will assign with 1. Once this is done, now what should we do next? If you observe, we need a loop to go through all these numbers. So the first term starts from 1 and it is supposed to go till n. So let me write here. So let me use the while loop here, right? Or you can use even for loop also. Let me use while loop. So here I should start from where 1, and here the condition, while i is less than k. So let me write here n, for just for the sake of difference here, I less than n. So I'll just print the value of a, because initially the value of a is printed, right? After that, I'll take a third variable, that is c, and then add this a plus b. Why? Because when we move to the next term, this a and b is added together to produce the next term, right? So that is why I will add this a plus b, and then if you observe, this a and b are getting exchanged. So for the next time, what happens? Your a gets the value of b. See, initially what was the case? This is your b, right? Now when this a and b shift like this, your a should get the value of b and b gets the value of this sum of the previous value, that is 0 plus 1, that is 1, is stored in this b. Again, this is the previous value of b. So while exchanging, this a will become 1 and b will become 1 plus 1, that is 2, and so on like this, this a and b will get exchanged. So how can we do that? So first of all, if you see, your a should get the value of b, right? Due to this structure, see, a gets the value of b and b gets the value of sum of the numbers. So your a should get the value of b, that is very obvious, and after that b should get the value of this sum of these two numbers, that is c. Now we'll try to analyze this code. Before we analyze, let us run this one, and I have to increment this value of I every time by 1. So let me run this, that whether it is working fine or not. So whenever you are not supposed to return anything, we don't write the return keyword here, right? Simply we just run this function as it is. So print a along with some tab character, right, slash t, for large amount of space. Now let me run this first of all. Okay, so I will enter the value of k as 10. So let me see whether I get this numbers from 0 to 34, so till 21. So I have to write here less than or equal to in order to get the 10th Fibonacci number as well. So let me write k as 10 So we got 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, 34. So let us try to analyze this particular function pf. Okay. So I'll just consider this piece of code. Just a minute. Let me move this toolbar here. And I will consider this line number 2 to 11 to understand that how exactly this function is working in order to produce the desired result, right? Now what happens, you see, if you observe, this line number 15 is the function call. So once the function call is made, your variable n, which is present in this function, gets the value, that is, consider it is 10, right? Now when your line number 3 executes, your a gets the value 0, fine. Then b gets the value 1, so b is your 1, okay. Then I initialize to 1. You can even write this code using for loop, there is no issue. Now the condition will be checked. So I is 1 and n is 10, condition is true, so we come here, print a. What is the value of a now? 0. So 0 is printed. After printing 0, don't print a new line, instead print a tab character, that means large amount of space, okay. So for printing tab character, we write slash n. And if you want to print new line character, you can use slash n like this, okay. Anyways, now when this line execute after the print line, c assigns a plus b. So what is a? 0. What is b? 1. So your c variable gets this value, 0 plus 1, that is 1. So 1 is stored in c. Now due to this line number 9, what happens? A gets the value of b. What is the value of b? 1. So a becomes 1 now. Now due to this line number 10, what happens? Your b gets the value of c. So effectively b remains unchanged. So if you observe here, your a and b got exchanged, right? So initially a was 0. If you observe here, a was 0 and then b is 1, right? Now this exchanged, right? So a became 1 due to this line, a assigned b, and your this b gets the sum of this 0 plus 1, right? Now your I will increment, that is, I will become now 2. So again the condition will be checked, this loop condition, 2 is still less than or equal to 10, yes, true. Now this line execute, that is a. What is the value of a now? 1. So after 1 is printed, one tab character is printed after 1. Then when this line execute, that is line number 8, what is the value of a? 1. B, 1. 1 plus 1, 2. So c becomes now 2 due to this line number 8. Now when this line execute, that is a assign b. So what is b now? 1. So effectively a is unchanged, that is a is 1 itself. And then due to this line number 10, what is c? C is 2. So this 2 will be stored within this variable b. Okay. Now due to this, your I will increment to 3. Now observe one thing. Your a and b got exchanged again. So a becomes your 1. Did you observe? And b becomes your 2 if you observe this place. Finally, what happens? The condition is checked. 3 less than 10. Yes. What is the value of a now? So 1 is printed. After printing the value of a, we are supposed to print a tab character. Print the tab character. Now come here. What is the value of a? A is 1. B is how much? 2. 1 plus 2 is 3. So c becomes your 3 now. When this line execute, a gets the value of b. What is b? B is 2. So a gets now 2. And b becomes your c. What is the value of c? C is 3. So b gets this number 3. So if you observe here, this a becomes your 2 and b becomes your 3. And finally, due to the next, this line number 11, what happens to the value of I? I increments to 4. Again condition is checked, condition is true. Again the value of a is printed. What is a now? 2. So 2 is printed and then tab character. In the same way, this a and b keeps on exchanging until this line number, till this point 34, we print all the numbers like this, right? So a and b exchange to 3 and 5. So 3 is printed and we get this 2 plus 3 equal to 5 stored in b. Then again 5, a is 5 and this b is 3 plus 5, that is 8. Again then a becomes your 8 and b becomes your 5 plus 8, that is 13. Then again a is your 8 plus, a is your 13 and b is your this sum of this 8 and 13, that is 21. Finally a becomes your 21, right? And then a, we print the value of this a with tab character, and then b gets the value of this 13 plus 21. Finally a is 34 and b is 55. And once the loop condition violates, that means once this value of I at some point of time when it becomes 11, finally this condition is violated and we come out of the loop and just this function is terminated, right? And hence we have this sequence of Fibonacci numbers, first 10 Fibonacci numbers, right? So let me run this code again for even printing the numbers till for the 15. Let us see if I print 15 here. So if I enter 15, we get the first 15 Fibonacci numbers. Now I want to modify this code in such a way, so instead of printing the Fibonacci numbers from 0 to given number n, I just want the nth Fibonacci number. That means if I enter the value of k is 15, only this number 377 should come. If I enter the value of k as 10, 34 should come. So how can we do that? Instead of printing this, I'll just return the value of a, right? I'll just return the value of a. Why? Because a contains my Fibonacci number, right? So let me put this in some variable r, let us say, and let me print the value of r. So let me give the message that kth fib assigns equal to, sorry, and here r. So let me see this code works fine or not. So I want to observe the 10th Fibonacci number. So if I enter 10, I'm expecting that I should be getting 34. So it is 55. Why? Because we are going out of the bounds. So what happens when your loop terminates? Finally your a becomes 55, right? A becomes 55. Why? Because of this 21 plus 34, that is 55. So that is why when once your this loop is terminated, your a is your 55. So in order to avoid that, to get the nth Fibonacci number, either we can just pass k minus 1 to get the 10th Fibonacci number exactly. So if you enter 10 now, you'll get 34. This is one of the way, and the other way is that in this loop you can just modify this part, that is I less than n. So in that case this a won't overshoot as compared to this 34, right? So if I run this now, it will still give me 34, right? So either you write in this function called k minus 1 or you modify this program. So better point is that let the function be as it is, because this is capable of printing the numbers, the first n Fibonacci numbers, as well as just with a small change you will get the kth Fibonacci number as well. So if I run it for 15, I'm expecting that 377 or something. Yes, 377 is the 15th Fibonacci number. Not only this, you can obtain any Fibonacci number. Let's say I want to observe this 34th Fibonacci number. So the 34th Fibonacci number is 352-4578, right? So I hope this program is clear, that how can we write a function even without a return statement, just to print values, and we can use, and this returning values you have been already writing so many programs, right, which were considering this return statement. So I hope this program of Fibonacci numbers, printing first n Fibonacci numbers as well as printing the nth Fibonacci number or kth Fibonacci number, is clear.